Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment, and the second is like, namely this, Thou shalt love thy neighbour as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Lord, have mercy upon us, and write all these thy laws in our hearts, we beseech thee. The Lord be with you. Please be seated. Welcome everybody to the 8 o'clock service here this morning, those present and those who are joining us online. Those who are online will not be aware this morning that we've had almost a false start because we had a late visitor who was obviously a stranger to this church and a stranger to our country. She was from Ukraine, and I wasn't sure whether she just wanted to come in and take a photograph of the church or say a prayer, or join us for the 8 o'clock service. So I woke Lynn up by saying, could you look after this lady? Within 3 or 4 minutes, she'd said her prayer and she'd gone. St. George's Church is extraordinary if you've never visited it, because all sorts of people wander through these doors at any time of the day or at any day of the week, and that it's that traffic of people that I want to speak to in a few moments' time. Let us pray. Let thy merciful ears, O Lord, be open to the prayers of thy humble servants, and that they may obtain their petitions, make them to ask such things as shall please thee, through Jesus Christ thy Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Amen. The epistle is written in the 12th chapter of the epistle to the Hebrews, beginning to read at the 18th verse. You have not come to something that can be touched, a blazing fire and darkness and gloom and a tempest and the sound of a trumpet, and a voice whose words made the hearers beg that not another word be spoken to them, for they could not endure the order that was given. If even an animal touches the mountain, it shall be stoned to death. Indeed, so terrifying was the sight that Moses says, I tremble with fear. But you have come to Mount Zion and to the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, and to an innumerable angels in festal gathering, and to the assembly of the firstborn who are enrolled in heaven, and to God, the judge of all, and to the spirits of the righteous made perfect, and to Jesus, the mediator of a new covenant, and to the sprinkled blood that speaks a better word than the blood of Abel. See that you do not refuse the one who is speaking, for if they did not escape when they refused the one who warned them on earth, how much less will we escape if we reject the one who warns from heaven? At that time his voice shook the earth, but now he has promised, yet once more I will shake not only the earth, but also the heaven. This phrase, yet once more, indicates the removal of what is shaken, that is, created things, so that what cannot be shaken may remain. Therefore, since we are receiving a kingdom that cannot be shaken, let us give thanks, by which we offer to God an acceptable worship, with reverence and awe, for indeed our God is a consuming fire. Here endeth the epistle. The Holy Gospel is written in the 13th chapter of the Gospel according to St. Luke, beginning to read at the 10th verse. Glory be to thee, O Lord. Now he was teaching in one of the synagogues on the Sabbath, and just then there appeared a woman with a spirit that had crippled her for 18 years. She was bent over and was quite unable to stand up. When Jesus saw her, he called her over and said, "Woman, you are set free from your ailment." When he laid his hands on her, immediately she stood up straight and began praising God. But the leader of the synagogue, indignant because Jesus had cured on the Sabbath, kept saying to the crowd, "There are 6 days on which the work ought to be done. Come on those days and be cured, and not on the Sabbath day." But the Lord answered him and said, "You hypocrites, does not each of you on the Sabbath untie his ox or his donkey from the manger and lead it away to give it water? And ought not this woman, a daughter of Abraham, whom Satan bound for 18 long years, be set free from this bondage on the Sabbath day?" When he had said all this, his opponents were put to shame, and the entire crowd was rejoicing at all the wonderful things that he was doing. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise be to thee, O Christ. May I speak in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. There's something extraordinary about this story from Luke's Gospel today. I don't know whether you've noticed it. Here is Jesus on the Sabbath and in the synagogue. It's thronged with people. People are coming to and fro. And he heals the woman with this extraordinary ailment. Her back is deformed. She's doubled up. And she comes into the synagogue, into the temple. What's extraordinary about this story is that she does not approach Jesus. Everybody else who needs healing either shouts out like Bartimaeus, blind Bartimaeus who can't get there, or actually approaches him. People flock to him to be healed. This woman did not approach Jesus. Her condition is immediately apparent to everybody in the vicinity. You can't hide it, bless her. Her spine is deformed. And when Jesus saw her, he called her over. "Come here, come here." And he said to her, in no form of dialogue, which so often happens with healing miracles, "Do you believe? Who do you think that I am? Why have you come to me?" He simply says to her, "Woman, you are set free from your ailment. Woman, you are set free." The other part of that dialogue is that the woman's need is visible and apparent to everybody. It's immediately obvious to anybody and everybody. But so many of the people who seek healing and who are so vulnerable and weak, their illness and their need and their vulnerability is inside and hidden. Now I say that because we have had a steady trickle of people in this last season of time who've come into this parish church with exactly such need. And I don't know, you probably haven't noticed them because they don't always come to this particular service and they don't always come to a liturgy itself. But the little trickle continues, rather like our Ukrainian friend who came in a few moments ago. St. George's is an extraordinary place because the doors are open every day of the year. So there's a constant movement of people. And lots of people have said that when they're in church doing something, arranging flowers or doing some cleaning or tidying up or preparing for a service, or just come in to say their prayers, that there's nearly always somebody else in the place. It's that sort of church. It's very visible, the doors are open, and it has a reputation for being a place of prayer. So people come. But in amongst that tide come some very vulnerable people, and they come here because I think they feel and they sense, first of all, that they will be safe. This is a safe port in a time of storm, and that also it's a place of peace and they may be able to receive help. Let me give you just a couple of examples, if I may. It was a while ago now, probably nearly a couple of years, when Diane, who's here this morning, came and knocked on my door, which is a brave thing to do because it was my And she said, Father, she said, I think you'd better come over to church. Diane was over here pottering on, doing one or two things. And so I came over with her. And we had a young woman here with a child. Both the young woman and the child were in their pajamas. Quite clearly, they were distressed and they were in need of a little bit of help. So we did what the Church of England always does in such circumstances. We brewed up a pot of tea, which is what you do, isn't it? And we made them warm and we got them some food. And then we sat down and tried to unpack gently what was going on and how we might help her. Well, to cut a long story short, that was years ago. That young woman comes back to see us from time to time, certainly to use the church for her private prayers, but she also has joined us for public worship as well. She just feels that we offered her something in a time when she was most vulnerable. But now, not everybody who's vulnerable appears in this church in their pyjamas. We had another lady who was visited at home. She felt drawn to come to St. George's, like so many, and yet she didn't have a great deal of courage to step across the threshold. And then, of course, COVID hit, and nobody could come across the threshold, at least for several weeks, before once again the doors were open. So a member of this congregation, Heather, used to take her the newsletter. Now, I'd begun to do this, but slowly we delegated it. And when I'd taken this lady the newsletter, I'd simply sort of pushed it through the letterbox. But Heather was much more pastorally sensitive than me, because Heather pushed the thing through the letterbox, rang the doorbell, walked to the end of the drive, and waited to say hello. Well, for lots of time, nobody came to the door, so she kept on doing it. And she just imagined that the reason was that the person behind the door was an elderly lady who was infirm and probably couldn't get to the front door too quickly. But nevertheless, she kept on putting the newsletter through the door and ringing the bell and waiting at the end of the path just to say hi. Well, one day the door opened and there was a young mom surrounded by her young children. That young mom had actually entered into a conversation with Heather as the weeks passed, and slowly she's had the courage to come here to this parish church. She's thinking about getting her children baptised, she's thinking about being confirmed herself. She has no clue what church is about. She's one of those people who've had a very difficult time in life, as so many have, and she's come here finding this church once again as a port in a time of storm. I don't know whether it's the same in the churches that you go to for those watching us today, but it seems to be a quiet and growing trend in this particular place and at this particular time that God seems to have sufficient confidence in the people of this place to say, you can take the people that are in need at this time, and he leads them here. And what's extraordinary is amongst this trickle, of whom I've mentioned just two, each and every one has said, actually, we felt called by God to come to this place. We felt that God was saying, you go there and you'll be all right. I think that's an extraordinary privilege, and we do what we can. I hope you keep your eyes open for such people in our community and in this church, for they will be here from time to time, they will be present, and they're needed to be welcomed not only with generosity, but with sensitivity and real warmth. Unlike the woman in Luke's gospel, they may not always be quite so visible, neither will their needs or their vulnerability, but truth to tell, it's there in full measure. In Jesus' name, amen. So let us stand and confess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven, Ghost of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again, according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sitteth on the right hand of the Father. And he shall come again with glory to judge both the quick and the dead, whose kingdom shall have no end. And I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Lord and giver of life, who proceedeth from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spake by the prophets. And I believe one Catholic and Apostolic Church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. We sit for the offering of the gifts. Let us pray for the whole state of Christ Church, militant here in earth. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications, and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal Church with the spirit of truth, unity and concord, and grant that all they that do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also to save and defend all Christian kings, princes and governors, and specially thy servant Elizabeth our Queen, that under her we may be godly and quietly governed, and grant unto her whole council and to all that are put in authority under her, that they may truly and impartially minister justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops, priests, and deacons, that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and specially to this congregation here present, that, with meek heart and due reverence, they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succour all them who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to give us grace so to follow their good examples, that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. Ye that do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins and are in love and charity with your neighbours, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession to Almighty God, meekly kneeling upon your knees. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, Maker of all things, Judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, in thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honour and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins to all them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Saviour Christ said unto all that truly turn to him. Come unto me, all that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul saith. This is a true saying, and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John saith. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him, and he in us. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. Who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, say, take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me." O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life.
Amen.
Take this in remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Amen. Take this in remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was shed for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life.
Drink this in remembrance of Christ's blood was shed for thee. Blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was shed for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Drink this in remembrance of Christ's blood was shed for thee.
The body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was given for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life.
Take in this in remembrance that Christ died for thee, and feed on him in thy heart by faith with thanksgiving. Amen.
Blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was shed for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life.
Drink this in remembrance that Christ's blood was shed for thee, and be thankful. God of our Lord Jesus Christ, which was shed for thee, preserve thy body and soul unto everlasting life. Drink this in remembrance that Christ's blood was shed for thee, and be thankful.
As our Saviour Christ hath commanded and taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us who have duly received these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favour and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of the most precious death and passion of thy dear Son. And we most humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honour and glory, world without end. Amen. Glory be to God on high, and in earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, art most high in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be amongst you and remain with you.